Okay, so I took apart two of the exact same camera, and I did it, to be honest, because I had some issues getting. I took the first one apart to identify the parts inside of it, and had some issues getting it back together because some of the screws just were stripped, and it wouldn't did not want to go back together. And so I bought another one and found out something kind of interesting. So this camera and a lot of products go through different revisions that don't necessarily show up in model numbers. So that means that the manufacturer may have found a better way or a less expensive way to produce something, and or it could be that they just found a cheaper way to produce something and were able to improve their margins. And so with this camera being so low cost, I'm sure the margins are very of a great deal of interest to the manufacturer. If you look, this one says version 3.8, and this one says version 3.3. So this is an older version. This version has an epoxy potted central processing unit or CPU, and this one has a just a plastic cover over it. So the plastic cover, it may not be as robust as the epoxy potting, I'm not sure. But it doesn't look quite as stable. You know, it'd be harder to mess up those wires. And when I pop this off, the wires are clearly messed up to the CPU there. And if obviously the boards are totally different colors, I guess that lets the manufacturer know that there are different revisions. If you flip the boards over, you can take a look at the. Let me zoom in just a little bit on this. You can see the charged couple device or the light capturing device is very different. So this one looks larger and more robust. This one looks a lot smaller. So it appears that what they've done is a cost reduction, probably a reason to change. Also, the onboard memory is a different manufacturer. So it may be that this memory is less expensive, the new memory. This board doesn't need this capacitor. And so perhaps this electrolytic capacitor was a cheaper way of storing a charge to during the photo process. And if you look at the lenses here, this one's got a big lens cover over it, and this one has no lens cover over it. So that probably added cost. I don't believe that's actually the lens. I think it's still that tiny little thing that you see inside this one here. But it looks bigger with that, and they probably just got rid of it to reduce cost. So anyway, that's the difference between the first or one of the earlier iterations and one of the later iterations. But as far as consumers go, you wouldn't know any difference at all when you bought the two cameras because they're virtually identical on the outside.